Hello dear learners, today we are going to talk about the MCQs from Pharmaceutical Chemistry 2, Practical Part, Part 2, that is from Synthesis again. In Part 1, we have finished with some general introductory part on Synthesis. In Part 2, we are going to cover few more MCQs from the same topic. So, to start with the Part 2, first question is, process of removing the impurities from the product is, whether it is purification, whether it is synthesis, whether it is recrystallization or acetylation. The correct answer is, it is purification. Removing the impurity and purifying the product is purification. Recrystallization is also the correct answer, but it is only one of the method of purification. It is not a complete 100% answer, because there are many other methods also for purification. Whereas the recrystallization is concerned, this kind of crystals we can obtain. There can be colored crystals also, some sample crystals. So, here in case of recrystallization, the impure substance is converted to pure substance by dissolving solid in hot solvent and let it cool to recrystallize. So, this is one of the method of purification, but removing the impurities from the substance is purification only. Next question is, identify the given image. As you can see here, this is a kind of funnel, but it is which funnel? Whether it is glass funnel, Buckner funnel, random funnel or none of them? The correct answer is, it is Buckner funnel. Next question is, identify the given assembly. Now, this assembly, as you can see here, this is getting heated. The round bottom flask and the condensate is collected in downside here in a particular container or beaker, you can call this conical flask or beaker. Anything you can collect, whatever you want. Only the thing is, the vapors get condensed and the distillate is collected. Then, this assembly is of, whether it is of distillation, synthesis, melting point assembly or none of them. The correct answer is, it is distillation assembly. Next question is, the weight of the product which one should get based on the stoichiometric quantities of the reagent is, whether it is practical yield, whether it is percentage yield, whether it is theoretical yield or none of them. The correct answer is, it is theoretical yield. Since theoretical yield is based on the molecular weight and stoichiometric quantities of the reagent, that is the proportion of the reagent used. Next question is, the weight of the product actually obtained after purification of product is, whether it is practical yield, percentage yield, theoretical yield or none of them. The correct answer is, it is practical yield. It is the actual yield. Practical yield is also called as actual yield, which is obtained after the purification of the product. Next question is, identify the given chemical reaction. The reaction is, from aniline, it is getting converted to acetanilide in presence of acetic anhydride and acetic acid in zinc dust. So, it is aniline to acetanilide conversion. This reaction, wherein the active hydrogen is getting replaced by acetyl group, is acetylation, since the acetyl group is getting substituted. So, whether it is hydrolysis, esterification, acetylation or none of them, the correct answer is, it is acetylation. Next question is, the significance of addition of zinc dust in acetylation reaction is, whether it reduces the color impurities from the aniline. Why do we add zinc dust? What is the reason? Whether it reduces the colored impurities from aniline. Whether it prevents the oxidation of aniline during the reaction, whether both of them or none of them. The correct answer is, it is both of them. Zinc dust not only reduces the colored impurities of the aniline, but it also prevents the oxidation of aniline during the reaction. Next question is, recrystallization solvent employed for purification of acetanilide is dash. Whether it is water and alcohol mixture, whether it is boiling water or only alcohol or none of them. The correct answer is, it is water and alcohol. As far as the synthesis of acetanilide is concerned, we used to have 120 ml of water and 2 ml of rectified spirit as the mixture as recrystallization solvent. Next question is, name the chemical which is not required for the acetanilide synthesis. Whether it is aniline, acetic acid, acetic anhydride or ester, the correct answer is it is ester, because you very well know that aniline with acetic acid in presence of acetic anhydride, it forms acetanilide. So, the remaining one is ester, which is not used in the acetanilide synthesis. Next question is, the intellectual skill required for the synthesis are, as you all know in the manual, initially in the introduction part, if you will see, there are intellectual properties and motor skills which are required to perform a particular part of practical. So, according to that, the intellectual skills required for the synthesis are dash. That means whether to understand the concept of the experiment, whether to understand the precautions which are to be taken during the practical performance, whether to plan the experiment and perform the calculations, or all of them. The correct answer is it is all of them. When you are comparing it with the synthesis, all the skills for synthesis, you need to understand the concept, yes. You need to understand the precautions which are to be taken, yes, very correct. You need to understand the precautions because you don't know about the nature of the chemical or any explosivity of the reaction or any effect, carcinogenic effect of any of the reagent or any other effects which are there. Then, to plan the experiment and perform the calculations, yes, you need to calculate the percentage yield. So, you have to perform the calculations and to plan the experiment for time management. So, the correct answer is it is all of them. Next question is, the motor skills required for synthesis are dash. Whether it is ability of group working, whether it is ability to work according to the plan, whether it is ability to handle the equipments or all of them. The correct answer is it is all of them. The motor skills required for synthesis are group working is also required, then according to plan work is also required, and how to handle the equipments also you need to know the things like these things. So, it is all of them. Next question is, the intellectual skill which is not required for the synthesis is dash. Whether to understand the concept of the experiment, to understand the precautions, to plan the experiment and perform the calculations, or to analyze and interpret the observation. The correct answer is it is to analyze and interpret the observations, because you need not to take the observations during the synthesis. Only the thing is, like, you need to get a practical yield and you put it into the formula and you get the percentage yield. So, this intellectual skill is actually not required when you are performing the synthesis. Next question is, the motor skill not required for synthesis is dash. Whether it is ability of group working, ability to work according to plan, ability to handle the equipments, or ability to refer the standard literature. The correct answer is it is ability to refer the standard literature. The procedure is being given to you. Everything you know from the instructions, and there is no need to refer to the standard literature as it is there in qualitative analysis or identification test. So, the correct answer is it is ability to refer to standard literature. Next question is, the given formula in the picture is actual yield divided by theoretical yield, that is practical yield divided by theoretical yield into 100 is of, whether it is of practical yield, whether it is percentage yield, whether it is theoretical yield or none of them. The correct answer is it is percentage yield. Percentage yield is actual yield divided by theoretical yield into 100. Next question is, the purpose of recrystallization is dash. Whether to obtain the pure compound from the impure one, whether to obtain the monoacetyl derivative of aniline, whether to synthesize various compounds or all of them? The correct answer is it is to obtain the pure compound from impure one is the purpose of recrystallization. Next question is, the process in which the compound is dissolved in selected solvent with heating and cooled slowly to saturated solution is the process wherein, as we all know, the pre-selected solvent is there. In the same solvent, the compound is made solubilized at higher temperature and it is made to crystallize out at lower temperatures. So, this process is whether sublimation, distillation, chromatography or recrystallization. The correct answer is it is recrystallization, wherein the compound is dissolved in the selected solvent with the heating and it is cooled to get crystals to form a saturated solution, and from that we get the crystals. With this, we finish with few of the MCQs from part 2, synthesis. Thank you. Stay tuned for the next parts.